enots Engineering. I'm Alan. In today's video we'll be looking at three jaw chuck jaws. I'll be setting the jaws up in the milling machine for grinding and showing you how to set them up and what to look for, but I'm not actually going to grind the jaws because I only did them about a year ago and I've already ground these twice on videos. So I'm just setting them up, showing you the setup, how you would do it to get a flat on the chuck jaw rather than a curve. Now obviously it depends on the jaw, whether you have a flat on there to start with or a curve. But on my Bernard True Grip, originally the jaws had a flat on there. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. This three jaw chuck I have fitted in the lathe is a Bernard Grip True, and originally each jaw had a flat surface. Obviously, as I've refurbished it and ground the jaws, it now has a diameter on the surface instead of the flat. So now the jaws look like this. The blue is where the original jaw would have been with a flat face, and the red is as the jaw is now with a curved face. Now, I was reminded by somebody who sent a comment on one of my jaw grinding videos who said that the original Bernard jaws were flat. That got me thinking that they couldn't have been ground in the chuck, so they must have been ground in a jig on a surface grinder, which is what you'd expect if you're
manufacturing jaws.
You wouldn't do them three at a time, you'd probably do them 20, 30 at a time, so they're all the same. Now this type of grinding will give you some problems. First one is if you're gripping a bar in the chuck that's smaller than the radius that's been ground on the jaws, you can see it will hold in the centre of the chuck. So when you tighten the chuck up, it will hold here. In the chuck, in that area, which is okay if you've got a small bar, no problem, still run true. You could find that the bar may turn in the chuck because of the reduced surface area holding the outside of the bar. And the opposite happens with a larger bar. Now if we use this to represent a larger bar, you can see that the chuck jaws are now touching on the edges, and I've had cases where you get extra marks on the outside of the bar where these edges dig into the bar. That's fine if you want extra grip on your bar, because you have six gripping areas, and with the smaller bar you only have three.
But you just need to bear that in mind when you're grinding your chuck. Check the type of grinding that was done before, whether it was round or flat, and try and copy what you had before. Now I know if I put these flat on my chuck, I can't get enough leverage on the chuck to grip some of the bars enough and they rotate in the chuck. So I'm happy with the way it is with the diameter on. But I just wanted to show you how you can grind the chuck jaws in a milling machine and get a flat surface. To grind them on the mill, first thing we need to do is check that the outside of the jaw on each one It's not damaged, hasn't been turned down, and it's as near as possible to the original condition. This is because we're using the outside diameter to line the three jaws up. Now on my chuck, it's not that critical. I can self-center it, so if it's a couple of thou out, I can just re-center it. But on a fixed three-jaw chuck, where you can't center the jaws, this is going to determine how offset the jaws are. So what we'll do is set it up in the vise on the milling machine, and then we'll check it with a dial indicator. The first thing to do is check that the top of your vise, the jaw, is parallel to your machine bed. If it's not, you'll be grinding an error into the chuck jaws. So all I've done is held the dial indicator in a collet lightly, don't need to grip it too tight, set it to 50 because it's easier to see there, and I'll run the and that's saying it's about half a thou over 4 inches, so that's acceptable to me. So we know that the top of the jaw is parallel to the machine bed, so for grinding we're only grinding a half a thou error into the chuck jaws. Take this out now. Okay, I've got the chuck jaws, and what I've done is lined them up in order, 1, 2, 3, and I'm going to rest each jaw on the outside diameter on the top of the vise. And it should sort of look like that. So I know they're in order of operation, and I know they should all be the same height. Because they're resting on top of the jaw. What I don't know now is if they're all true that way. So what I want to do is clamp them together so they're all held together, and then just tap them down onto the vise and lock the vise up. Now I've held them on the top of the jaw and clamp them all together so they're in order and act as one block. Now if I've got it right, each of these jaws should be the same height and they should be level. I've changed the dial indicator to a dial indicator that reads a tenth of a thou. So from 0 to 10 is a thou. In the 1.5 thou taper. So if I go along to the next jaw, So at this end I'm half a thou down the bottom of the jaw curve. I'm 7/10 down this one. A thou down. So I have a half thou difference between the three. And get back to the other end of the jaw. Get the lowest reading. That's 10th now. Seven tenths down. Seven tenths down. So they all seem reasonably true to each other. I'll run along the curve on this one. Zero at this end. Tenths. So that's the setup for grinding. I'm not going to grind these flat because I only ground this set of jaws about 3 months ago. I've ground them twice for videos. I'm happy with the way they are at the moment. But if you do want a flat rather than a curve, so what I'll do next is fit my grinding wheel into the head. Now we discussed this in the last two videos, so if you haven't seen it you can look at the last two videos, shows how we made it and a test on it. Put the grinding wheel in and then just take off whatever you need. If you want it flat you'd have to take off about this one. That's not too bad. It's two thou. So if I took two thou off all those jaws it'd be a flat jaw as it was originally. As with all grinding operations, wear eye protection and put guards around in case the grinding wheel shatters or parts fly off. Now that should, if I grind that should give me a good finish and each jaw will be true to each other. I'm not relying on the scroll to chew the jaws up. I'm relying on the original manufacturing diameter, which is within a few tenths. As I said, I'm not going to grind these at this time, but you can see how the grinding wheel is fitted and how it can cover the surface of each jaw. This just shows you the clamp resting on the vice jaw and holding all the chuck jaws together. And each chuck jaw has been tapped down onto the top of the vise. And the vise has been clamped to the jaws to hold them firm. Oh well, thanks for watching. Hope that was interesting. And we'll see you next time on enots Engineering.